Welcome, welcome, welcome to One Piece Chapter 917 Review, titled Food Treasure Ship. The cover story continues on with Bellamy's quest to become an artist of flags, where we can see him drafting out a flag that looks very much like a Straw Hat Jolly Roger. Now, what his exact purpose in all of this actually is, but my theory is that he might be designing a wide array of Straw Hat pirate flags to hand out to those who are in alliance with Luffy and his crew. Now, we continue on in Leftover Town, where we, you know, get a little bit more of a glimpse of the dire strait of the little town, where many children are going hungry and are desperate to have food, with one man even going up to Suru and stating that his child was unable to bear the hunger and ultimately drank river water, much like Tama herself, and this man is begging Suru for a cure. However, on the flip side, we go into Bakura Town, deep within it, to the Paradise Plantation, where there is plentiful food and a wealth of resources. And the workers who toil and labor there are given a meager, minuscule fee, pittance, I guess you could say, for their hard work and effort. And one man even goes so far as to claim, like, this will not even feed my children, sir. But he's shooed away by the gifters, as if he were nothing. We are then introduced to Speed, who has obtained the horse smile. Now, my initial thoughts on Speed's design was it looked a little odd with the fact that, you know, part of her body, you know, when you get to her regular front legs, they look very much like a regular human female's. But the further down you go, it looks like horse legs, and the edge behind her is a horse's body. But then I kind of had to remind myself that the smile devil fruits are very much incomplete products and don't always have, I guess you could say, novel effects on the host body. So I guess it kind of makes a bit of sense that her body is kind of odd in a way. We went from regular humans with weird proportions to actual animal people, and now we have people who are just a odd mixture of the two. And this woman, Speed, very much has a smile like a horse. As she goes about entering the very area where Hold'em and Luffy are having their bit of a stare down, she finds that Hold'em's mansion is on fire and has become utterly engulfed in flames. Speaking of which, we cut back to Hold'em keeping Tama in his belly, which we come to find is named the Lion Kimijiro, who, you know, is shown very much to have a mind of its own. But he's obeying Hold'em's commands and will crush Tama should, you know, Luffy step out of line. Now, Kiku warns Luffy to not attack Hold'em, which should immediately be a red flag for anybody who's, you know, even so much as met Luffy, not to attack Hold'em, as he is one of the headliners who are underneath Jack the Drought. Zoro notes that Jack was the person who was taken down by Zoe and went sinking into the bottom of the sea. However, Kiku says that in truth, Jack had just appeared not that long ago, and should they anger Hold'em in the least, Jack's revenge will raise the town to the ground. Luffy notes that he's basically holding the entire town hostage, and he even starts to crush Tama a little bit in order to threaten Luffy even more. Speed ultimately arrives with the food ship, a giant bountiful meal for all the people who live in that town. This angers Luffy even more at the fact that they're hoarding such an excess of food from people who are starving. Ultimately, Luffy has had enough and tells Zoro to deal with the minor fodder while Luffy goes and deals with getting Tama back himself, even though Kiku is very much warning against it. Meanwhile, as Hawkins manages to arrive at the entrance of Bakura Town, he is met with Law, who has a basket hat over his face in order to hide his appearance, as Hawkins would be one of the very few people who would know what Law looks like. So I'm very excited to see what goes down between Hawkins and Law. Meanwhile, in the display of unfathomable speed, Zoro and Luffy quickly go on the attack, whereas Luffy bashes Kimijiro in the face in order to recover Tama, whereas Zoro starts slicing up all of the fodder soldiers and uses the lion dog in order to abscond with the food ship, bringing it back to Leftover Town. As Luffy asks if Tama is okay and inquires why her cheeks seem to be so bruised, Tama notes that Hold'em had tried to pull out her dongles with pliers. This pisses Luffy off to no end, and you might as well stop calling Luffy Big Brother and start calling him Papa Bear, because he has rage in his eyes, the likes of which I have almost never seen for anything outside of a close personal friend of his. So he ends up relenting onto Hold'em, and whereas we find out that Hold'em's lion can actually breathe out fire, of all things, this doesn't affect Luffy in the slightest, and he bursts through Hold'em's fireball and delivers a vicious red hawk right to Hold'em's face, the very thing that Kiku had told him not to do. And with this, Jack the Drought is certain to get involved in challenging Luffy, which I am all too ready to see, because we need to find out where Kaido's subordinates, his calamities, stack up against Big Mom's sweet commanders. As we have been shown, the sweet commanders are on a whole nother level and are Luffy level or above. So, by that theory, if Jack the Drought doesn't show that he is a unfathomable force to be reckoned with, or at least show the same capacity for taking on a challenge as we saw from Cracker, then that kind of diminishes Kaido's street cred to a certain degree. But Jack the Drought has been like such a notable presence for so long, it's about time we finally get a fight proper with him. Just see what someone named a Calamity, of all things, can actually do. Not to mention, who will the other Calamities be, and what will their epitaphs be as well? Will we have the tsunami, the hurricane, the earthquake, the volcano, some other natural disaster, the plague maybe? Like, who else is in command of Kaido's forces? And how long will it take before Big Mom also arrives on the scene? Not to mention, we also know that X-Drake is involved with Kaido, as well as Scratchman Apoosh. So where will those two factor in at any point? Because they are, in fact, Kaido's forces, and Kaido's forces operate outside of Wano. So naturally, if with Luffy being in that home territory, we're bound to see them come into play somewhere down the line. Not to mention, with the fact, I keep saying that, with the fact that Kid is locked up by Kaido somewhere, will Kid ultimately become, you know, an ally to Luffy and Law as well? And we'll see a kind of reworking of the first time all three of them met during the fight in the Shabody Archipelago at the auction house, with the three of them standing side by side taking out Kaido's forces. You know, I would love to see it with each crew just kind of mounting an attack against each calamity and then coming together in order to take on Kaido. Because if Big Mom is anything to go by, Luffy alone will not be enough to stop the likes of Kaido. He could barely even put a scratch on Big Mom. It's gonna take a lot more than just him to take on the beast, Kaido. But tell me your thoughts on this chapter in the comments below. Where do you think all of this will be leading, and what kind of retribution will come down upon this town because of Luffy's actions? Will Jack the Drought stomp out Leftover Town permanently, or will our heroes manage to, you know, bring about the rainy season once again, and plentiful food will be given to the masses? And please leave me a like or a dislike depending on how you felt about this video. It lets me know where I stand, and subscribe for more One Piece reviews. It's been a great showing so far, and there's no signs of stopping.